My name is James. Today we're going to be making a tuna tartare recipe. Actually, it's not my recipe, it's one of Jason Atherton's, a chef that I used to work for in London. It's a nice recipe, and we're going to make a relish with this as well today, so it's going to be very elegant and very nice. If you don't have everything, like always, don't worry about it, because even today I don't actually have everything for it. I'm missing some limes, and I'll have to substitute with just some lemons. But anyway, guys, as always, feel free to like the video down below, subscribe as well if you haven't done so already, and substitute any of the ingredients if you don't have them, because, like I said, I don't as well. So let's get started with the recipe. So first we're going to start the relish, because it's going to take the longest amount of time, and there are a lot of ingredients for the relish. But mostly, and most importantly, we're going to be using some shallots. I don't have banana shallots, I have the smaller ones. So I'm going to use a few more, and you want to peel them, leave the bottoms on, cut the tops off, cut them in half, leave the bottoms on, peel them, and then finely slice them. If, like you see in the video, like I'm doing, just like an onion, you're going to burn was. If you can't do it this way, not to worry, just go through it with a knife again and again and again until you get it to a very fine consistency. You're gonna do the same thing for the garlic. And this time cut the ends off, crush them, and then slice them, and then dice as well, and chop, chop, chop until they are a very fine consistency. Then I'm going to take the ginger. You're gonna take the skin off of it first, then you're going to take a grater. It doesn't have to be a microplane, it can be a normal one. A microplane will work better though. And you're just going to grate on the cutting board as you see in the video, nice and slow. Watch your fingers when you do this, because I have cut myself before when I was younger, doing this a little too fast. So once you have all of this ready, then we're going to focus on the chilies. Now if you have, or if you can get some red chilies, great, or you can even use some Thai chilies. I have a few dried cayenne peppers, because I can't really get a lot of chilies. I have to go to a specialty place to actually find them, so I'm just going to use some cayenne. You can throw them in dry since we're going to be cooking them. If you want to rehydrate, you can as well. It's totally optional. So once you have the garlic, the shallots, the ginger, and the chilies all cut up, we're going to measure out our sesame oil, and we're going to add it into a small to medium sized saute pan. The recipe that I'm doing right now is half of the actual recipe of Jason Atherton's. So if you want to make the full recipe, just double everything and saute this until the shallots are tender. So about 6 to 8 minutes, more or less. Use a spatula, keep an eye on it, and occasionally stir it. Now while this is cooking, you're going to measure out the rice wine vinegar and also the mirin. And then after the shallots are tender, you're going to add this to the saucepan, and then you're going to let this reduce until it's a thicker consistency, a jammy consistency. You'll actually see this, because we're making a relish, it's going to have a very, very nice texture at the end of it. So after about 10 minutes, we're going to measure out our soy sauce and add this in. You're going to continue cooking, continuously stirring it, or occasionally stirring it, keep an eye on it. And we're going to cook this until the soy sauce has reduced by about half, more or less. Don't cook this too fast, because with the soy sauce, if you put this on high heat, you can easily burn it, as well as the sesame oil, and then it's gonna have a very nasty taste to it and flavor, and you're not gonna like it. So slow cook this until it's at the consistency that you see in the video. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take the pan off the heat. You're going to weigh or measure out the amount of fish sauce and lime juice, if you have limes. If you don't have limes, you can substitute with lemons. It's gonna have a bit of a different flavor to it, but it still works because it's acidic. So then you're going to add both the fish sauce and the lime juice to the mixture after it has cooked, and once the heat is off, mix it in. Then you're going to put it in a pan or a bowl and just let it sit. Then we're going to take a handful of cilantro, or about 1 tablespoon more or less. Pick it, don't use the stems, and make sure that it's good cilantro. If it starts to turn color, like the chives, throw it out. Don't use cilantro if it starts to turn yellow or if it smells, throw it away. So we're gonna slice this very thin, as you see in the video, and then we're going to add this just before serving, after the relish has cooled. Now the ingredients for the tuna tartare are going to be more or less the same. We're gonna be using some toasted sesames. If you don't have them toasted, you're gonna have to toast them yourself in a shallow pan. And then I'm also gonna be using some soy sauce, as well as some sesame oil, olive oil, salt, and wasabi paste. If you don't want it spicy, leave the wasabi paste out. And again, you can feel free to substitute or change this recipe as you see fit. All right, now first I'm going to slice the chives. You want to slice them as thin as possible. If you have a Japanese knife, you can cut them a lot thinner than, say, my German knife, my Wusthof. But just for the house, it really doesn't matter. Just slice them as thin as you can, about a handful, more or less. Set them aside, clean the cutting board, and now we're going to work on the tuna. The tuna that I have, this is the amount that I got from the fishmonger, and more or less, it's a good piece of tuna, it's clean. There's a thing though with the tuna, as you can tell in the video, there's a bit of sinew on the bottom side, or the bottom piece, and then a very dark piece, which is the bloody piece. Now, since this piece is so large, I'm gonna first cut it in half, and then cut each piece in half again. For the top piece, since it doesn't have as much sinew or ligament, it's easier to cut. You don't have to separate each piece of the meat to actually slice it, and just cut slowly with it. You can stack each piece on top of each other, as you see I'm doing, but it's a good idea to clean your knife once it gets a little dirty or a little hard to cut, because with tuna, it will start to stick to your knife consistently. So wipe it and wash it with a damp cloth, or run it under some cold water. Then for the bottom piece, another method of doing this is when you have a piece that has a lot of sinew, but a lot, the bottom piece I cut off, but there are still a few lines of sinew, as you can tell, in the meat. Now, as you see that I'm cutting, cut as closely as possible to this sinew, and then you're going to cut it off. And you're just going to slice it off as close as possible, or cut as close as possible to it, so you don't waste a lot of meat. Now, if you don't really care or mind having a lot of sinew in your tartare, then you don't have to do this. But if you don't like having a lot of sinew and it sticking in your teeth and things like this, this is one method of taking it off when you have a piece already pre-cut from the fishmonger, instead of having an actual large piece, which is actually easier to cut if you have a large tuna. It's easier to cut the whole thing than it is a small piece like this. But anyway, you're gonna cut about 5 millimeters, more or less. If the pieces are a little too big, you can go through it again with your knife until you get to a consistency that you want. It doesn't really matter. And then after you have everything cut, you're going to take the tuna, put it in your bowl, and then we're going to measure out the amount of soy sauce, the sesame oil, the olive oil, the sesame seeds as well. You're gonna add a bit of salt and wasabi at the end. And then we're going to mix. And then after you mix it, give it a taste. If it needs a little more salt, or if you want a little spicier, add more wasabi. And that is pretty much it. So guys, this recipe is super easy to make, especially if you don't make the relish. And if you just make the tartare, it'll take you less than 10 minutes, seriously. Or less than 15, depending on how good you are with the knife. But tuna goes well as a appetizer, as a starter, and you can make hors d'oeuvres out of this. But if you are making this ahead of time, be sure to keep it in the fridge, maybe a little bowl of ice underneath it with a bit of paper or whatnot to keep the tuna cold, because when you're making tartare, it's important to always eat it as fresh as possible so you don't get sick. So for more recipes and information, guys, or more travel videos, be sure to like the video down below, subscribe, and if you have any questions or comments, be sure to ask me down below, as always. I'll see you again soon, and take care.